हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई वेलकम यू इन लेक्चर नंबर 30 ऑन हायर ऑर्डर ODEs। इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अनदर मेथड फॉर फाइंडिंग पर्टिकुलर इंटीग्रल नोन एज मेथड ऑफ अनडिटरमाइंड कोएफिशिएंट्स। एज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अर्लियर दैट टू फाइंड आउट पर्टिकुलर इंटीग्रल और पर्टिकुलर सॉल्यूशन वी हैव थ्री मेथड्स। वन वॉज डिफरेंट शॉर्टकट मेथड्स, second is method of undetermined coefficients, and third is method of variation of parameters. So we have already discussed shortcut methods for particular integrals, and today we will start with method of undetermined coefficients, and after completing this we will discuss method of variation of parameters. Now as we have discussed in shortcut methods, that shortcut methods are having some limitations. They are applicable to particular right hand side functions only, or we can say that they are applicable to special right hand side functions. So same thing is with method of undetermined coefficients also. Method of undetermined coefficient is also applicable to special right hand sides, and the thing which is similar to shortcut method is the functions on the right hand side in shortcut methods and functions in the right hand side in method of undetermined coefficients are same. If you remember, we have discussed that shortcut methods are applicable if right hand side is exponential function, sine or cosine function, or polynomial function, and some product and subtraction of these functions. If right hand side is exponential, sine, cosine, or polynomial, and sum and product, with sum we can include subtraction of all these functions, then we can apply shortcut methods to the given non-homogeneous differential equation. So same thing is with method of undetermined coefficients. So we can call these as special right hand sides to which shortcut methods as well as method of undetermined coefficients is applicable. Now what is special thing about these functions is, suppose I have this function e raised to 2x, say r equal to e raised to 2x, then if I consider first derivative of e raised to 2x, I will have e raised to 2x into 2. Second derivative will be derivative of this, which is 2 into e raised to 2x into 2, that is 4 times e raised to 2x. Similarly, third derivative will be 8 times e raised to 2x. So if you observe, each derivative of e raised to 2x contains this function which is repeated. There is no other function in any derivative of this function, or every derivative of e raised to 2x can be written as constant multiple of e raised to 2x. We can see r dash equal to 2 into e raised to 2x, here a equal to 2, r double dash is 4 into e raised to 2x, that is a equal to 4 here. In this case, third derivative is a equal to 8. So every derivative of e raised to 2x is nothing but constant multiple of e raised to 2x. So that is the characteristic of this function. Similarly, suppose I consider x cube, then first derivative is nothing but 3 into x square, second derivative is nothing but 6 into x, third derivative is nothing but 6, and all the derivatives will be 0 if n is greater than or equal to 4. So which functions we are getting in each derivative? So in first derivative we have x cube function, here x square, here x, and here we can say that constant function 1, and here 0. So what we can observe is any derivative of x cube can be written as linear combination of these three functions. If you observe, functions are 1x and x square. So I can represent every derivative of this function rx equal to x cube as a linear combination of these three functions. Linear combination means a into 1 plus b into x plus c into x square. This expression is known as linear combination of these three functions. So we can see, if we start with r equal to x cube, that is zero derivative, then here I have to add one more function. We have up to x cube. So if I consider linear combination of these four functions, 1, x, x square and x cube, then it is a into 1 plus b into x plus c x square plus d x cube. So r equal to x cube can be written in this form with d equal to 1 and other coefficients as 0. 0 into x square plus 0 into x into 0 into 1. Similarly, first derivative is 3 into x square. So c is 3, other coefficients are 0. So 0 x cube plus 3 x square plus 0 into x plus 0 into 1. Similarly, r double dash is 6 into x. So 0 into x cube, coefficient of x square is also 0. Coefficient of x is 6 and coefficient of 1 is 0. And so on, r triple dash, that is third derivative, is 6 into 1. So 0 into x cube plus 0 into x square plus 0 into x plus 6 into 1. And fourth derivative has all the coefficients 0. 0 into x cube plus 0 into x square plus 0 into x plus 0. So in general, we can say that every derivative of this function r equal to x cube can be expressed in this form as a polynomial of third degree. This is nothing but polynomial of third degree or linear combination of the functions 1, x, x square and x cube. So this is another function in which all the derivatives can be written as a linear combination of these four functions. Suppose I have x raised to n, then every derivative of x raised to n can be written as linear combination of 1, x, x square, x cube and so on, x raised to n minus 1, x raised to n. We consider another function. Suppose we have rx equal to, say, sin 2x. Then first derivative will be cos 2x into 2, that is 2 cos 2x. Second derivative will be 2 into derivative of cos 2x is minus sin 2x into 2, that is minus 4 into sin 2x. Similarly, third derivative will be minus 4 into 2 into cos 2x, that is minus 8 cos 2x. And we can have one more fourth derivative, that is going to be plus 16 into sin 2x. So here also we can observe that every derivative contains these two functions, sin 2x and cos 2x. Or every derivative can be written as a linear combination of cos 2x and sin 2x. If you observe, I can write any derivative of sin 2x in this form. If I consider r dash equal to 2 cos 2x, then here a is 2, b is 0. If I consider second derivative, then I have minus 4 sin 2x, that is b equal to minus 4 and a equal to 0. So this function sin 2x is special type of function. The characteristic is any derivative of sin 2x can be written as linear combination of two functions, cos 2x and sin 2x. So these functions are those type of functions, polynomial functions, exponential and sine or cosine functions. The characteristic of these functions is that any derivative of these functions can be written as a linear combination of finite number of functions. So the set of those finite number of functions is known as family of derivatives. If we consider this function e raised to 2x, then the function which is repeated is nothing but e raised to 2x. So family of derivatives of this function is e raised to 2x. Similarly, if we consider x cube, then every derivative of x cube can be written as linear combination of these four functions. So this is family of derivatives for function x cube. If we consider x raised to n, then this is the corresponding family of derivatives for x raised to n. If we consider sine 2x, then this is the family of derivatives corresponding to sine 2x. So in general, for this method, we must have the idea of family of derivatives for a given function. Suppose we consider rx on this side, and here we try to write down corresponding family of derivatives. So suppose I have e raised to ax, some constant into e raised to ax, then we will ignore the constant, we will concentrate on the function only. So family of derivatives for this right hand side will be e raised to ax. Suppose I have k into sin ax or k into cos ax or linear combination of both these functions. I can have k into sin ax plus some another constant into cos ax also. So here the functions which will be in every derivative will be either sin ax or cos ax, or any derivative of this function sin ax or cos ax is linear combination of these two functions. So this is the corresponding family of derivatives. Suppose I have polynomial function, say if I have x raised to n only, or I can have nth degree polynomial. Then because I have x raised to n here, I will start from 1 and I will go up to x raised to n. So this is the family of derivatives corresponding to this polynomial function. Now suppose we have two functions in the addition or subtraction. Suppose I have x square plus e raised to 3x, then the family of derivatives corresponding to addition or subtraction will be union of corresponding families. The family corresponding to x square is 1x x square, and the family corresponding to e raised to 3x is e raised to 3x. So the family corresponding to this summation of these two functions is nothing but union of these two families. So we know how to find out union of two sets. We have to write down all the elements which are present in both the sets. So 1x x square union e raised to 3x. So this is the family corresponding to this sum of these two functions. If they are in subtraction, then also we will consider union. But suppose same two functions are in the product, then for product we have to multiply, or we have to take Cartesian product of these two sets. So here I will not consider union, I will consider Cartesian product of these two sets. So that means 1 into e raised to 3x, that is e raised to 3x, x into e raised to 3x and x square into e raised to 3x. Similarly, suppose I have x cube plus sine 3x, or we can have only sine x. Then because these two are in the addition, we consider their union of corresponding families. Family corresponding to x cube is 1x, x square, x cube. Family corresponding to sine x is sine x, comma cos x. So the family corresponding to sum of these two functions is union of these two sets. So this is our corresponding family for this function. So this is necessary to understand the method of undetermined coefficients. Suppose I consider x into cos 2x. Then these two functions are in the product, so I will consider Cartesian product of corresponding families. The family corresponding to x is 1 comma x, and the family corresponding to cos 2x is cos 2x comma sin 2x. So here I consider Cartesian product. So I consider 1 into cos 2x comma 1 into sin 2x, then x into cos 2x and x into sin 2x. So if two functions are in the product, then we will consider their Cartesian product. If they are in the addition or subtraction, we will consider the union of corresponding families. Here these two I have considered as a sum, so I consider 1x cos 2x sin 2x. So here I have to take union of these two sets. So you can understand the difference. Here two functions are in the product, so I have taken Cartesian product of corresponding families, and here two functions are in the addition, so I have taken union of corresponding families. So here I have four functions, here also four functions, but functions are different. So this is required to understand the method of undetermined coefficients. So again we repeat, method of undetermined coefficient is applicable for particular right hand sides, which are exponential function, polynomial function, sine or cosine function, and linear combination of these three functions, as well as product of these three functions is allowed. So to understand the method of undetermined coefficients, we must remember this idea of family of derivatives. So the family of derivatives corresponding to e raised to ax is e raised to ax. The family of derivatives corresponding to sine or cosine, or linear combination of sine or cosine, is nothing but set having two functions, sine ax, cos ax. And family of derivatives corresponding to x raised to n is 1x, x square up to x raised to n. So we will start from x raised to 0, that is 1, and we will go up to x raised to n. So with this we conclude this session, and in the next session we will see how we will use family of derivatives to find out particular integral in the method of undetermined coefficients. I hope you like this. Thank you very much.